Hi, I'm Bill Griffith, an application engineer with Agilent Technologies. And today I thought it'd be interesting to build a temperature probe to use with our 34410A multimeter. I have a pre-built temperature probe. This is the E2308A temperature probe. It has a sensor on one end. It has a banana plug on the other. And it's built with a shielded twisted pair cable. The shielded twisted pair cable has a very tight loop area which cuts down on injected noise. For our temperature probe, we have a choice of temperature sensors. First, the thermocouple, which isn't a very good choice because the thermocouple has a large thermal mass. So it'll actually act as a heat sink, pulling heat away from our component, and it will not measure correctly. A better choice is the RTD or thermistor. Both the RTD and thermistor are resistive devices that change their resistance based on temperature. The RTD is known for being a bit more accurate, it has a larger temperature range, and is a little bit more expensive than the thermistor. For bench applications, the thermistor is a very good choice. It has good accuracy, it has a good temperature range, and it has a lot of sensitivity to changes in temperature. So we're going to go ahead and use a thermistor for our temperature probe. Here's our completed temperature probe. As you can see, we have the thermistor on one end of our shielded twisted pair cable and some banana plugs on the other end of it. We've connected it to our 34410A multimeter, and now we can go ahead and set up the 34410A for temperature measurements. It has many different built-in algorithms for measuring temperature. As you can see, it can measure RTDs or it can measure thermistors. So I'm going to select a two-wire measurement for our thermistor. Then we need to select the value. This is a 10K thermistor, so I'll select 10K. And I'm going to go ahead and select the rest of the defaults for our measurement. Okay, as you can see, the multimeter is now measuring temperature. I'd like to show some other neat features that this multimeter also offers for temperature measurements. The next one is math. So we have a choice of doing limit testing or statistics. I'm going to select statistics. And as you can see, we can see the average, the max, and the min measurements of our temperature. So one more feature I'd like to show you is the data logging feature. So we can go ahead with our data logger and set up a set of measurements over a period of time. So we're going to set a 1 second scan interval, and we can either do it a number of readings. We can select either to do 100 readings, 1,000 readings, or we can set a duration. So for this, I'm going to set a duration. So I'd like to take readings for up to 1 minute, separated by a second. So I've gone ahead and entered those parameters, and then we'll go ahead and start our data logging. So you can see the DMM as it starts to complete, it counts down the number of readings left and it has an indicator showing the progress. In addition to that, you can also go back to the math that we had enabled earlier, which is nice, so you can get some idea of the readings as they're taking place to make sure that they make sense. So this is a very useful feature when you want to do a temperature profile of, say, a component on a circuit board. You can go ahead and glue your thermistor to the component, set up data logging, and measure it over a period of time. So that's what I wanted to show you today, how easy it is to build a temperature probe and use the 34410A for making temperature measurements. Thank you for watching.